fatigue, weakness, decreased performance often manifest before anemia itself actually manifests, because cells are struggling. They're struggling to create enough energy to meet the demands of the cells. And over, I see patients and athletes suffering with chronic symptoms that are related to iron deficiency and are cured by simply getting iron repleted. You know, these symptoms of headache, depression, sleep disturbance, dry skin, restless legs, palpitations, shortness of breath, just general feelings of exercise intolerance, even weight gain, hair falling out. These can all be manifestations of iron deficiency without anemia on the human body. If you haven't already done so, would you please take a moment and subscribe to the DR Wholeness channel so you don't miss out on any health accumulation opportunity. Iron deficiency anemia affects 1.2 billion people. Iron deficiency without anemia is shown to be at least twice as common. So iron deficiency without anemia, it refers to a lack of iron stores to meet the requirements of one's body, regardless of whether or not a complete blood count, CBC, demonstrates a low hemoglobin level. Even though a CBC may come back showing hemoglobin in the normal range, iron deficiency still decreases hemoglobin synthesis. So you might have a normal hemoglobin, you know, on your CBC, but if you're iron deficient, you're still decreasing that synthesis. And even though it is well established that iron plays an indispensable role in both myoglobin and hemoglobin synthesis, its role in mitochondrial function, it's often overlooked. And we've heard the mitochondria, what are they? They are the fuelers, the promoters of energy production in our cells. Iron is equally valuable and is required in the creation of cofactors and enzymes to enable energy production within a cell. The mitochondria need it so bad. Your heart muscles, your leg muscles, your basal ganglia, basically the air of your brain that filters incoming information from moment to moment and then suggests, what is the best action I take now that I've received this information? Those are all dependent on iron for optimal functioning. If you are underperforming, get your CBC checked, get your transferrin saturation checked, get your TIBC, total iron binding capacity checked, get your ferritin checked. And remember, getting your serum iron levels checked to diagnose iron sufficiency or deficiency is a very, very poor test. As iron, if you have found this content helpful, hit the subscribe button. Let us know your iron story and be sure to get your ferritin levels checked. I'm Dr. Matt, and I'll see you next time.